فؤادك الأيام فتى
وما بعلة الغموض أو خفى معلل عندهم قد عرفا. The author rahimahullah ta'ala, now he's talking about the hadith which is defected. We spoke about a bit about it. A hadith which is mu'allal. A hadith mu'allal means a hadith which has a defect. But when you look at it from the apparent, it seems pure and clean. Nothing's wrong with it. But who are the people who are able to realize that this hadith is mu'allal, this hadith is defected? Are the who? The scholars. They are called the jahabidatul nuqad, the scholars of hadith who reached the pinnacle of hadith. They will look at it and say, this narration is defected. It is what? It is defected. So they realize it. And there are ways scholars would realize it. Inshallah ta'ala, in my sharah of Ikhtisar Ulum al-Hadith, I will inshallah ta'ala explain in more details there. Not even my sharah, my nukhbatu al-fikr. So, وَمَا بِعِلَّةٌ غُمُوضِ أَوْ خَفَى مُعَلَّلٌ عِنْدَهُمُ قَدْ عُرِفَى. The scholars of hadith, the hadith which is defected, is غُمُوض. غُمُوض means it's hidden. Your eyes can't see it. Then عِنْدَهُمُ قَدْ عُرِفَى. مُعَلَّل is what it's known according to those people, the scholars of hadith. They consider it that this hadith is what? It's مُعَلَّل, it's defected. That's what they consider it as, that it's a defect hadith. And the types that it occurs in the hadith which is mu'allal is two types. Mu'allalu sanad, it either happens in the chain of narration or it happens in the matan. It happens in the chain of narration or it happens in the wording of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There's a defect in it. How can one really know how the hadith is defected? As I said, inshallah ta'ala, I will speak about it in details in Ikhtisar Ulum al-Hadith. But one of the ways to realize it, that summarizes all those points, is jam'u al-turuq. The person sits down, the scholar sits down, and what does he do? He brings all of the chain of narration regarding this hadith together. He puts it all on the table. He looks at it from all the books, you see? And then he looks at the differences between each one. He compares it with one another. And then he compares each individual with the other individual. Everyone, he compares it with the other one. And then he realizes, if the hadith is mu'allal, ama ma'lul, he will realize it and mention it there, rahimahullah. They will know it there. So it occurs in it occurs in two ways, mu'allal al-sanad and mu'allal al-matn. Na'am. The example of the hadith which is mu'allal al-sanad is the hadith of Abi Ya'la ibn Ubaid, who narrated from Sufyan al-Thawri and Amr ibn Dinar and Ibn Umar, marfoo'an, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-bay'ani bil-khiyari ma lam yatafarraqa. This hadith, the scholars they considered it to be mu'allal, defected. Why? The person who done the mistake is Ya'la ibn Ubaid. He ascribed this hadith, the shortcoming that he done was, he said that Sufyan al-Thawri said an Amr ibn Dinar. Rather, it's not Amr ibn Dinar, it is Abdullah ibn Dinar, his brother. So based on that, that's a defect. The scholars, they know how he got it. They realized that he got it wrong. Ya'la ibn Ubaid, to ascribe it, to say, an Sufyan al-Thawri. An Amr ibn Dinar, it should have been an Abdullah ibn Dinar. So this is what? It is weak. But the hadith is still authentic. Mu'allal al-Matn. The hadith which is mu'allal al-Matn is the hadith which negates qira'at al-basmala fi salah. The narration that says that reading the Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim in Salah, which is narrated from Anas ibn Malik. From Anas ibn Malik. That hadith is a narration which Imam Muslim rahimahullah ta'ala is alone in. He only singled in it in his sahih. From the whose path? From Al-Walid ibn Muslim. And the scholars who considered it, defected it, were many. From them, Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, Al-Daraqutni, Al-Bayhaqi, other than them. Na'am. Very good. Mm-hmm. Okay. وَذُو اخْتِلَافِ سَنَدٍ أَوْ مَتْنٍ مُضَّرِبٌ عِنْدَ أُهَيْلِ الْفَنِّ. The author goes into مُضَّرِب, the hadith that contradicts. وَذُو اخْتِلَافِ سَنَدٍ أَوْ مَتْنٍ, the hadith which contradicts itself. Huh? وَذُو اخْتِلَافِ سَنَدٍ, its chain of narration. So the author mentions the types there are. There are types of hadith which are مُضَّرِب. One is what? مُضَّرِبُ السَّنَدْ and مُضَّرِبُ الْمَتْنِ. The scholars of hadith, what do they do? وَذُو اخْتِلَافِ سَنَدٍ أَوْ مَتْنٍ مُضَّرِبٌ عِنْدَ أُهَيْلِ الْفَنِّ. They consider that مُضَّرِب, whether it's the matn, if it contradicts itself from the matn, or it contradicts itself from the chain of narration, this is called a مُضَّرِب, contradicted. An example for that is the hadith narrated by Abu Hurairah, Ibn Hibban, Abu Dawood, Ibn Majah, Ibn Khuzaym, Al-Bayhaqi. All of them narrated that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, إِذَا صَلَّ أَحَدُكُمْ فَلْيَجْعَلْ تِلْقَاءَ وَجْهِ شَيْئًا فَإِنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ فَلْيَنْصِبْ عَصًا فَإِنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ مَعَهُ عَصًا فَلْيَخْطُطْ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ خَطًّا ثُمَّ لَا يَضُرُّهُ مَا مَرَّ أَمَامَهُ. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they said, he said عليه الصلاة والسلام, that if one of you prays, then he should place something in front of him. If he can't find it, let him put a stick there. If he is unable to find a stick, then draw a line in front of yourself and then don't worry, it will not harm you, anyone who tries to go in front of you. This hadith, it is ikhtilaf occurred. فهذا الحديث اختلف على الراوي. The narrator, dispute occurred regarding him. And the narrator here is Ismail ibn Ulayya. Ismail ibn Umayyah. And the reason why there came a lot of differences is this. The reason why there came these different contradictions is as follows. It is said sometimes, and from him, Ismail ibn Umayyah, sometimes that he said, and an Abi Amr ibn Muhammad ibn Huraith, an Jaddihi Huraith, an Abi Huraira. And sometimes it said that he said, an Abi. عن أبي عمر ابن محمد ابن عمر ابن حريث عن جده حريث ابن سليم عن أبي هريرة. And more came. More than 10. So, more than one scholar, such as Sufyan al-Thawri, ibn عبد الهادي رحمه الله, and other than them two, they what? They consider this hadith to be اضراب السند. That the chain of narration is مضرب. If you wish, you can look at the kitab Fath al-Mughith, which is the Sharh al-Alfiyyat al-Iraqi by Shamsuddin al-Sakhawi, rahimahullah. The second type is Muddarib al-Matan. The hadith is Muddarib in terms of its matan, the wording. And that is the example of Tirmidhi's word, hadith narrated by An Sharik, An Abi Hamzata, An Shabi, An Fatima bint Qais, radiyallahu ta'ala anha, qalat su'ila Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam an al-zakati, faqal inna في المال لحقا سوى الزكاة. إن في المال لحقا سوى الزكاة. Ibn Majah narrated it in a different wording, which is ليس في المال حق سوى الزكاة. So this hadith, one time Fatima bint Qais is being narrated by Tirmidhi that she said when she was asked, when she narrated it. She said that the Prophet ﷺ was asked about zakat, and he said, "Inna fil mali," that inside the wealth there is rights other than zakat. In another narration of Ibn Majah, she said, "Laysa fil mali haqqun siwa zakat." In the wealth, there is no right except the zakat. So both contradicting one another. Iraqi said, فَهَذَا اضْضِرَابُ لَا يَحْتَمِي تَأْوِيلٌ. This hadith is called مُضَّارِبْ اضْضِرَابُ. It has no other interpretation. There's no way to bring it back together. One is saying left, one is saying right. One is affirming, one is negating. So this is called مُضَّارِبْ. السَّنَد. مُضَّارِبُ الْمَتْن. The wording, one is saying this and one is saying that, becomes مُضَّارِبْ الْمَتْن. وَالْمُدْرَجَاتُ فِي الْحَدِيثِ مَا أَتَتْ مِنْ بَعْضِ أَلْفَاظِ الرُّوَاتِ اتَّصَلَتْ. مدرجات. مدرجات means هو الحديث الذي يدرج يعرف أن في سندي أو متن زيادة ليس منه. That the hadith inside it, there is an additional, either the chain or the wording of the hadith. There is an additional thing in it that is not from the original hadith. Where did this come from? The additional. It came from one of the narrators. He added something to the chain. Okay? He added this to the chain. Why would a narrator do that? The reason why he will do it is one of these two reasons. One of these two reasons. Either he did it because he wanted to explain what a word meant. So he didn't stop the hadith. As he was narrating the hadith, he in the middle, he tried to explain what a word meant. So the people thought that the Prophet said this. So they wrote it down. So this is called tafsir ghareeb, or tawdih mushkil, or bayan mujmal. Or sometimes, it is a mistake that occurred from him. And books have been written in that regard, the issue of mudraj. The best book written on that is Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi, Al-Faslu lil-Wusuli lima udrija fil naqli. An example of the two types, which is mudraj al-sanadi and mudraj al-matni. The mudraj al-sanadi is in the chain of narration. Somebody adds something to it. مَا رَوَاهُ التِّرْمِذِيُّ that which Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated مِنْ طَرِيقِ ibn Mahdi, يعني عبد الرحمن بن مهدي عن سفيان الثوري عن واصل بن الأحدب ومنصور والأعبش عن أبي وائل عن عمرو بن شرحبيل عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قلت يا رسول الله أي الذنب أعظم قال أن تجعل لله ندا وهو خلقك الحديث. Good. This hadith is mudraj al-sanad. The chain of narration is what? Is mudraj. This chain of narration is mudraj. Why? Because the individual in there is wasil al-ahdab. Wasil al-ahdab. He didn't mention wasil al-ahdab. He didn't mention in his chain of narration Amr ibn Sharhbil. He didn't mention that. But it's narrated from who? Abi Wa'il. وَإِنَّمَا يُرْوَى عَنْ أَبِي وَائِلْ عَنْ إِبْنُ مَسْعُودٍ. Rather, Wasil al-Ahdab, in his chain of narration, it is not mentioned Amr ibn Sharhbil. Rather, he goes directly from Abi Wa'il, directly to Abdullah Mas'ud, don't mention Amr ibn Sharhbil. So, where did this additional name Amr ibn Sharhbil come into the chain of narration and it was additional added to it? It came through the narration of Mansur and Sulaiman ibn Mahran al-A'mash. Because how many people narrated it? We have Wasil al-Ahdab, we have Mansur, we have Sulaiman ibn Mahran. All of them, they narrated it from Abi Wa'il, Amr ibn Sharhbil, and Abdullah ibn Sa'ud. Wasil al-Ahdab's narration from the three, his one is not in there. What's not in there? Amr ibn Sharhbil is not in there. But the narration of Mansur and Sulaiman ibn Mahran, they have Amr ibn Sharhbil. Naam. So the correct way to say his name, inshallah ta'ala, is Amr ibn Shurahbil. Naam, Amr ibn Shurahbil is his name. Naam. So we mentioned Mudraj al-Sanad. Mudraj al-Matn is what's left now. It's the hadith of Abi Huraira. Alhamdulillah. Yahdikum Allah, yuslah alaikum. It's the hadith of Abi Huraira, which is marfoo, narrated by Imam al-Bukhari al-Muslim. للعبد المملوك أجران والذي نفسي بيدي لولا الجهاد في سبيل الله والحج وبر أمي لحببت أن أموت وأنا مملوك. Abu Huraira said that the Prophet ﷺ said that the slave has two rewards. The slave that is owned has two rewards. And I swear by the Lord in which my hand is in his soul. If it wasn't jihad for the sake of Allah, if it wasn't for Hajj and the obedience of my parents, and obedience to the parents, I would have loved to die as a slave. I would have loved to die as a slave. This hadith is mudrajul matn. Huh? This hadith is what? It is mudraj as-sanad. Where he says, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِ I swear by the one whose soul my hand is in. That is kalam of Abu Hurairah. Huh? Mm-hmm. So this is from the part where he says, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ I swear by the one whose hands my soul is in, لَوْ لَلْجِهَادُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَالْحَجُّ وَبِرُّ أُمِّي لَحَبَبْتُ أَنْ أَمُوتُ وَأَنَا مَمْلُوكُ is the statement of who? Abu Hurairah. All of that is the statement of who? Abu Hurairah is mudraj. Why is it mudraj? How do you know it's mudraj? Because it's impossible that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would ask Allah to be a slave. Plus his mother wasn't even alive for him to be obedient towards her. Alayhi salatu wassalam. He reached the best thing that anyone could ever receive, which is to be the messenger and the prophet of Allah. So that's called mudrajus matn. وَمَا رَوَى كُلُّ قَرِينٍ عَنْ أَخِي مُدَبَّجٌ فَعَرِفُ حَقًّا وَانْتَخِي. The author, inshallah ta'ala, he's talking about something called al-mudabbaj. But for us to know what a mudabbaj means, we have to know what aqran means. Aqarin means. Aqran are contemporaries. They are the narrators who are either close in age, they're not far off from each other in terms of age, they're close to each other, or they are close to each other in terms of chain. They took from the same scholar, so they like that. They're called what? Aqran. So what does mudabbaj mean? Mudabbaj means if the two aqran narrate from one another. They narrated from each other. Two aqran are narrated from one another. It's called mudabbaj. The hadith is called what? A mudabbaj. For example, Aisha narrates from Abu Huraira. Aisha and Abu Huraira are both what? A companion. So they're aqran. Or Abu Huraira narrating from Aisha. That's called aqran. Tabi'een, for example, Zuhri narrating from Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. Or Umar ibn Abdul Aziz narrating from Zuhri. They're all tabi'een. So they're aqran. You see, Imam Malik narrating from Auza'i. Or Auza'i narrating from Imam Malik. This is, they're all both what? Atba'u tabi'een. They are aqran. They're contemporaries. You see? The Shaykh says, مُدَبَّجٌ فَعَرِفُ know it. حَقًّا وَانْتَخِي. وَانْتَخِي means what? A iftakhir anta bima'rifati. Be pleased with knowing it. Huh. Boast about knowing this issue now. Know this. So that is called what? It is called aqran. The example for that is the hadith which Imam al-Hafidh ibn Hajar mentions in Fathul al-Bari. He mentions in Fathul al-Bari. Which is the hadith min tariq Sulaiman ibn Bilal an Abdullah ibn Dinar an Abi Salih an Abi Hurairah an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-Iman bid'u wa sab'una shu'bah. This hadith, Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he says, fil isnad al-madhkur riwayatul aqran. In this hadith, there is the narration of aqran narrated from one another. Abdullah ibn Dinar an Abi Salih. Abdullah ibn Dinar and Abi Salih. Abdullah ibn Dinar and Abi Salih, both of them are tabi'een. Both of them are what? They are both tabi'een. So, فَإِذَا وُجِدَتْ رِوَايَةُ أَبِي صَالِحًا عَنْهُ. So whenever you find a narration of Abdullah ibn Dinar narrating from Abi Salih, then this is called what? صَارَ مِنَ الْمُدَبَّجْ. It becomes a hadith which is mudabbaj. They're both two contemporaries. They're narrating from one another. نعم. Then the author, rahimahullah, he said, مُتَّفِقٌ لَفْضًا وَخَطًّا مُتَّفِقٌ وَضِدُّهُ فِي مَا ذَكَرْنَا الْمُفْتَرِقِ. The author, he talks about muttafiq and muftariq. Muttafiq and muftariq. What does muttafiq and muftariq mean? It basically means individuals whose name, the way it's pronounced and the way it's written, it's the same, but they're different individuals. Like for example, Khalil ibn Ahmed. There are six people who are called Khalil ibn Ahmed. From them was Khalil ibn Ahmed al-Farahidi, Shaykh Sibawayhi, Imam Sibawayhi's teacher. But there are other five individuals who were given that name, Khalil ibn Ahmed. Okay? Now, when you're writing it, you write Khalil ibn Ahmed. Another one, Khalil ibn Ahmed. So in terms of writing and in terms of pronunciation, it's Khalil ibn Ahmed. Okay? But they're different to people. So this is, that's called what? Muttafiqu lafzan wa khattan muttafiq. In terms of writing, in terms of reading, everything is the same. Okay? Writing is the same. The recitation and the reading is the same. But they are what? They're different people. They're not the same person. Also the same is Ahmed ibn Ja'far ibn Hamdan. Four people are called in it, and all of them lived at the same time. They were all fi asrin wahid. The author then goes on to another type, which is called mu'talifu muttafiqu al-khatti faqat wa dhidduhu mukhtalifun fakhsha al-ghalat. Now he goes into what is known as mu'talif and muttafiq. Mu'talif and muttafiq are people who, when you write their names, the only difference between the writing of the name is the dots faqat. Every one of you try to write Abbas and Ayyash and try to tell me what's the difference between the two. It's only the dots. In Arabic, if you write Abbas or you write Ayyash, it's only the dot. The dot for the ya and the dot for the sheen. For example, if you write salam, and if you wrote salam, what's the difference between the two? Again, it's the tashkeel, the way you write it. One is takhfiful lam and the other one is tashdiduha. The difference is only the signs. And back at those days, there wasn't like that. They didn't have these dots and these harakat. They didn't have that. So for them, it was what? Abbas and Ayyash was written the same. Their memorization, they will know it. And there are others who are falling into that. So that's what he means by mu'talif and mutafiq and mukhtafiq and mukhtalif. Mutafiq and muftariq. Very good. The author then goes on saying, وَالْمُنْكَرُ الْفَرْدُ بِهِ رَاوٍ غَدَى تَعْدِيلُهُ لَا يَحْمِلُ التَّفَرُّدًا. Munkar is a narration where a person who's weak, he does opposition. A weak person does opposition. Now if a reliable person opposes, it's called shadh. But when a weak person does the opposition, it's called what? Munkar. Pay attention. That is the difference. That they share, both of them share something. The shadh and the munkar, both of them are opposition. But one is from a person who is strong and on point. The munkar is that a person who is weak. فحش غلط كثرة غفلته. Ha. And then he falls into what? مخالفة الرواية الثقات. He opposes reliable individuals. It's called munkar. It is called what? A munkar. Then the author says, مَتْرُكُوا مَا وَاحِدٌ بِهِ انْفَرَدْ وَأَجْمَعُوا لِضَعْفِهِ وَفَوَكَرَدْ. Matruk means what? It is what one individual is alone on. If one individual who's weak is alone on, and his weakness is unanimously agreed upon, he's excessively weak. Maybe his weakness is مُتَهَمٌ بِالْكَذِبِ. He's suspected to lie, you see? Or he excessively gets it wrong. Or he's excessively heedless. Okay? This individual, his narration is what? His narration is, and he's alone on it. It's called matruk. And every example for that is the hadith, Amr ibn Shimr, al-ju'fiyu al-kufiyu al-shi'i, and Jabir, he narrated from Jabir, and Abi Tufail, and Ali, wa Ammar, qala, that they said, kana Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqnutu fil fajr. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do what? He used to do qunut in fajr. وَيُكَبِّرُ يَوْمَ عَرَفَ مِنْ صَلَاةِ الْغَدَاتِ. And then the Prophet ﷺ used to do takbir from the morning prayer. وَيَقْطَعُ صَلَاةَ الْعَصْرِ آخِرَ أَيَّامِ التَّشْرِيقِ. And he used to disconnect and stop صَلَاةُ الْعَصْرِ, the last days of أَيَّامُ التَّشْرِيقِ. This hadith, as Imam al-Nisa'i and Dharqutni and other than them mention, that Amr ibn Shimr, his matruku al-hadith, his hadith is not taken into consideration. So he said, مَتْرُكُ مَا وَاحِدٌ بِهِ انْفَارَدْ. وَأَجْمَعُوا لِضَعْفِي فَهُوَ كَرَدْ. It's like what? That is rejected and is given no weight. وَالْكَذِبُ الْمُخْتَلَقُ الْمَصْنُوعُ عَلَى النَّبِي فَذَلِكَ الْمَوْضُوعُ. The author now is talking about the fabricated narration. The fabricated narration is a hadith which is made up on the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It doesn't matter, brothers and sisters, whether that person deliberately lies on the Messenger or they didn't intend to lie about the, on the Prophet. it doesn't matter, the hadith is considered mawdu', fabricated. It's considered what? It is fabricated, it's considered, it's called fabricated, and it's not taken into consideration. Wujuduhu ka'adamu, its presence is like its absence. It has no weight whatsoever. From the ahadith which are placed, and sometimes there are motives behind why people will place fabricated ahadith, is because they probably want to spread their madhab, for example. Like, for example, that which the mutaassibi al-madhab al-hanafiyya, those who are blind followers, who are fanatics on the madhab al-Abu Hanifa, they, for example, made a hadith that they said that the Prophet ﷺ said, siraj ummati, that the candle of my ummah is who? Abu Hanifa. Abu Hanifa is. So this hadith is fabricated, it's made up. For example, the hadith that was made up, Aliyun khayrul bashar, Ali is the best of creation. Man shakka fihi, anyone who had disputes in it, kafar, he's a disbeliever. This hadith placed by the Rawafid, the Rafidah, they place this hadith. And finally, the author concluded his book by saying, وَقَدْ أَتَتْكَ الْجَوْهَرِ الْمَكْنُونِ سَمَّيْتُهَا مَنْظُومَةَ الْبَيْقُونِ فَوْقَ الثَّلَاثِينَ بِأَرْبَعٍ أَتَتْ أَقْسَامُهَا تَمَّتْ بِخَيْرِ قُخُوتِمَتْ. He said, this book has come in pearls, al-jawahir, al-jawhar, al-maknoon, pearls that were stored, it has come in it. سَمَّيْتُهَا, I called it مَنْظُومَةَ الْبَيْقُونِ. I called my book مَنْظُومَةُ الْبَيْقُونِ. فَوْقَ الثَّلَاثِينَ بِأَرْبَعٍ أَتَتْ. It has come in 34 lines. أَقْسَامُهَا, its types, تَمَّتْ, is complete, بِخَيْرٍ خُوتِمَتْ, with Allah تبارك وتعالى's aid and help. And we conclude there, inshallah تعالى, اللهم اجعل هذا العمل خالصا لوجهك وانفع به المسلمين واغفر لمعلميه ومدرسه ولوالديه ولمشايخه والحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.